Good evening.
Good evening, everyone.
And indeed, Jesus is our God who will be blessing us through His Word. It's not a coincidence, but our first text is found in John 15:11, and the following is Psalm 16:11. And one of the 11 verses that is my very unang-unang na-memorize na verse when I was young is John 10:11. I would say, I am a good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for his sheep. So, tayo po yung manalangin at may the Lord bless us as we will feast upon His Word. Let us pray, Father, we come before you with humble hearts. We are so thankful for you are a good, good Father. That's who you are. And in spite of who we are, you invited us in your presence right here, right now. And we are promised with your presence. And in your presence, there is fullness of joy. In your right hand, there are pleasures evermore. So help us to have this smiling face all throughout as we would talk about your word. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay. I titled our short meditation this evening, Having a Happy Heart. Hindi naman Valentine's, pero gandang pag-usapan ang tungkol sa puso. Our heart is not just a physical thing that pumps blood all over our body. Hindi natin pag-usapan ang physical side niya, but we are going to talk about how the Lord blesses our hearts with joy, goodness and happiness and blessedness. Okay, how to have a blessed heart or a happy heart? Ang sabi ni isang quotation, a life that is lived for fun is fruitless. But a life that is filled, or the life that is lived without fun is unbearable. Diba? A joyful life, it means an outward expression of happiness. Like just a simple smile. Tingnan nyo nga yung katabi nyo kung marunong bang smile. Smile na lang dyan. Okay? So lahat naman po tayo nakapag-take na ng selfie. Though hindi alam nyo mga kasama nyo sa bahay or sa opisina, you have already taken your selfie even once. Kahit isang beses na ako, ano kayo ng selfie. And you try your best to smile. Diba? Ako yung winning mo selfie, but I tried. May huli nga ako selfie kanina, as before we met here. At it is evident that a person is happy or blessed or joyful when you can see the smile on their face, right? Well, hello ma'am, sir, welcome to McDonald's. Welcome to Jollibee. Exactly. Jollibee. It's always the smile that speaks of a happy well-being inside, or a happy heart. And tanong dito, do you think God wants us to be happy?
Yes.
Meron po presidential or senatorial candidate last time na nasa Pilipinas ako, and then kami. And then, meron siyang katagalo na hindi ko talaga makakalimutan. Sabi niya, si Drille, gusto ko happy ka. Nakakilin o lahat sa tarpaulin, di ba? Darwin, nakita mo doon, gusto ko happy ka. Mayroon siya pinakausap na artista na nagpo-promote sa kanya as incoming senator. And this senator is has this tagline to make people really choose him because everybody wants to be happy. Di ba? Sa hirap ng buhay sa Pilipinas, isa lamang po ang goal about us at the end of the day is to be happy. Kahit tayo naman po. Diba? Meron din po tayong kataga or kasabihan, happy wife.
Happy wife,
di ba? Okay, so ako'y nag-aagi mo doon. I'll never imagine my household without a happy Kathy. Okay? Speaking about Kathy, she's not here because we messed up with the schedule of the concert of my daughter, CJ, at siya sana yung presider. Good thing is that si Tita Joseph. Always ready, parang girls come. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, there are three things. God wants us to be happy. And there are three things that hinder Yung bumabalaki. There are three things that hinder you or us to have a happy heart. It is very important to have a heart that is happy, dahil it makes you look nice, di ba? Tuwing umaga, pag nakita mo yung mga katrabaho ko at grumpy yung tsura nila, di ba? Hindi ko happy. No? Kanina, pag-isip ko, medyo sumakitang ulo ko dahil hindi ako nakatulog. Ang hirap matulog sa sopa. No? Tinay ko matulog sa sopa. Ito, ganun ko ang gusto sa manood ng parang scenery channel. No? That brings me to some other place like Paris, Bahamas, Boracay. Ganyan na ako dun. Pero ganda kasi sa scenery, gusto makatulog doing that. Nakatulog na ako, pero pag-gisip ko mulat ko, sakit ko yun. So, hindi ako nakapagtrabaho ng maayos. And after my lunch, or during lunch, sabi ko, Sir, uwi po ako. Uwi na po muna ako kasi meron pa lupa eh. Yay! Hindi ko naman magsisigawa eh. Hindi, meron talaga. So, paghandaan mo itong gabi dito. Okay, there are three things. One, letter R. One of the things that hinder a happy heart is rebellion. Rebellion to God's authority over your life. Okay? I want you guys, as you listen to the Word of God tonight, to reflect it as God is speaking to you personally. Wala kang iwas-iwas, walang ilan-ilan. Tayo pong kakusapin ng Panginoon. First thing that can hinder a happy or blessed heart is rebellion. Can a person be rebellious to God? Yes. Can a pastor be rebellious? Yes. Then a pastor po, tama din. Okay? We sometimes have this level of thinking of like, Lord, I don't go in. I don't want to do my best. Like that. So it's kind of going against what the Lord wills in a certain thing for you to do. Rebellion. So Psalm 32, we can find that David was so miserable. Meron siya kasalanan na very prominent and it's found in Psalm 32. Hindi naman natin babasahin yung buong chapter. David was miserable during the time that he had kept silent. Okay? Karoon siya ng silence that time. He had rebelled against God's authority and broke God's law. This is called sin. Yung kasalanan ko ang siyang isang subject that would create breakage. It's the circuit is really flowing, but this is the circuit breaker. Okay? So, yung sin po, nagkaroon ng chance to really stop the joy of being in the presence of God. Remember, sa Garden of Eden, they were fellowshipping with each other in a joyous manner. They were so blessed. They had all their, what they need. Walang bahay na kasalanan. And then, so happened, by one man, sin entered into the world. And that is the breakage. He broke the relationship between God and man. And of course, we know that Jesus came to fix the problem. Diba? Yung breakage natin eh. And He wants us, Jesus wants us to have a fellowship with God again. Because sabi niya natin, God wants us to be happy. See, talking about David, he had not confessed and forsaken the sin. He said that God's hand upon him was so heavy. However, after he confessed his sin, ito po nangyari, and had his fellowship back to God, it had this, what we call, from the breakage, it came on a restoration. Remember that David is not a perfect person. He already had his issues. He got his issues, he got his dysfunctions. He got his attitude. Diba? Nagkaroon siya ng isa siya person that is like you and me. But at the end of the day, he was called the man after God's own heart. Diba? Pwede din ba tayo maging a person of God's own heart? Yes, tonight, I promise you that God wants us to be happy and He wants us to be like David. Another nagkaroon ng restoration. He described his experience, dito sa Psalm 32, of his heart as blessed experience. It's a blessed experience. Sa Psalm 51 naman, David asked God to blot out his sin, or to wash away the sins from his heart. He acknowledged his sin and asked the purging from his sin. Pag sinabi ko purging, parang mas malalim pa yun sa paghuhugas. Inaalis talaga pang ipin yun at pinatanggal bago pastahan. Yun po ang yung principle of being purged into cleanliness. No? David described it as washing of his sins. And the result of this is cleansing and renewed heart. Ang sabi niya doon, create in me a new heart,
a clean heart,
and give me this kind of spirit na kailangan para maging blessed ang kanyang buhay. Okay, finally, he asked God to restore the joy of his salvation. There is no such thing as a perfect follower of Jesus Christ, but there is no such thing as sinless child of God. Diba? Sa isip ng salita at sa gawa tayo may nagkakasala sa ating Panginoon. We do not lose our salvation if we sin. Yeah, we do not lose it. But what sin does pag tayo nagkakasala, nawawala yung joy natin. Diba? Sabi nga sa principles of the Bible, we say, the devil cannot steal your heart, but he wants to steal your joy. Now, joy of what? Joy of being a child of God. Joy of being saved. You are saved, but you're not feeling the happiness about being saved. That's the work of the devil. But you know what? We have a God who's always trying his best to restore the joy of our salvation. 1 John 1:9 would say, ito po niya tawag na believer's bar of soap. Pag-inigo tayo, sino po ba nito ang nag-inigo bar of soap? I do. Naghahanap pa rin ako ng Irish Spring. Ayaw yung blue, gusto ko yung green. No? Magiging perfect yung old day. Okay? Bar of soap. If we confess our sins, we are dirty, he is faithful, and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. God wants us to be happy and God wants us to be sinless before Him, and He is the only one who can do that. His blood can wash away our sins. And holiness is possible when we ask God to forgive us, and happiness comes after it. So if you want to be happy, the secret is do not rebel against God's authority. Number two, resistance to God's Holy Spirit. Resistance. Malay po ang passages dito, but the summary of this would say like, when God has been offended, is it possible for God to be offended? Yes. Sometimes, parang, ay, inulit na naman. Ay, yung anak mong yun, nakala ko, tumalikod na yun. Tumalikod na naman. Ito yung tawag breathing of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes the Holy Spirit cannot really move inside you because you're trying to do something else. Diba? That's grieving the Holy Spirit, and God is being offended every time we sin. We must make things right with Him, and His Holy Spirit convicts us of being a sinner. Every time you sin, the Holy Spirit will whisper to your ear left and right, hindi na totoo ka ang Panginoon. Kaya nga kung meron tayo sa mga equal yung border na WWJD. Ano yung sabihin na? What would Jesus do? What would Jesus do? Meron ba dito na sa Canada? Yan. Meron yung t-shirt, meron yung sa globe o yung cap. Diba? And the Holy Spirit always does His function in our lives. That is to convict us. Ayun ka na naman. Diba? Kasabihin siya ng Holy Spirit in a way na, ayun ka na naman. Mag-click ka na naman ng channel. Diba? Kailangan mo na mag-devotion. Kailangan mo na prayer, fasting, may devotion na doon, mahaba-haba yun. Diba? Naka-record naman sa PBR yan. Mamaya mo na gawin yan. Pero inuna mo, ang PBR, nalimutan mo lang ngayon mag-pray at mag-join sa aking lalaki at magpo-comment ng amen. By the way, thank you for those who are liking and commenting amen sa ating post every day in our emphasis week. The practice of repentance and confession is not pleasant. Confession and repentance is not pleasant, but it is the only path to peace. Gusto niyo po ng kapayapaan? Tayo po ay mag-reconcile at huwag natin i-resist ang gawain ng Banal na Espiritu. sa buhay natin. So first is, do not rebel. So rebellion against God is a hindrance. Resistance to the Holy Spirit is a hindrance. And third, but not the least, of course, resentment of God's image. Resentment of God's image. Ano ibig sabihin ng resentment? It's also known as dislike, bitterness, antipathy. Hindi antipathy. Antipathy ko. Siguro galing yun, ano? Antipathy or hatred. Sa book of Hebrews chapter 12, verse 15, if you can turn your Bibles there, you can find the word trouble. And it literally means crowd in and defiled. Means contaminated. Diba? Bitterness will sour you and those with whom you come into contact. Contagious po ang niyatawag na resentment or dislike or bitterness, apathy or antipathy or hatred. Bitterness is formed by unresolved conflict. Bitterness is formed by unresolved conflict. So Ephesians 4:26, you can find it there. It is always wise to sleep on important decisions, but never rest your head on a pillow of bitterness. Ulitin ko po, ganda, pang Instagram. Hashtag, don't. Parang ito. It is always wise to sleep on important decisions, but never rest your head on a pillow of bitterness. Sa mga mag-asawa, do not let the sun go down on your wrath. Diba? Kahit yung mag-asawa, nagkagalit kayo, the same one single long pillow pa rin ang iuna ninyo. Kung sabihin, pero mag-asawa pa rin kayo. Diba? Mag-asawa pa rin kayo. Sa Matthew 18, you must forgive others. And God won't, so God will forgive you. Ang ngayon, ano, no? Parang may condition. If you want to be forgiven, forgive first. Well, that's how God wants us to know forgiveness and to feel forgiveness. If we forgive others, then we will really feel the forgiveness of God. Diba? That gives us peace. Diba? Meron pong kasabihan na talagang naukit po sa puso ko, sabi dito. Offense is an event. Offended is a decision. Uy, pag Instagram. Ulit, no? Ulit ikaw. Offense is an event. But being offended is a decision. Kung hindi tayo marunong magpatawad sa ating mga kapwa, lalo sa mga household, okay? What is it to us? Parang hirap dalhin. So your heart will never be happy if you have resentment or dislike, bitterness, antipathy, or hatred with your brothers and sisters. Job 42 verse 10, God is the judge. Let him. Job had become bitter over the false accusations of his friends. The bitterness of his heart had made him a captive. No? Kung tayo po pala ay itatago ng sama ng loob sa kapwa, sino po ang kawawa? Malay mo, yung naka-offend sa'yo, hindi niya alam na na-offend ka niya, eh ikaw ay habang buhay ng masama ang loob, eh siya nakikita mo may happy heart dahil nakasmile niya sa'yo. Pag i-smile ka pa dyan, na-open mo ako last year. Umaba na lang, umaba ang panahon, yung parang hindi niya alam na na-offend mo siya. Pag na-offend mo tayo, the Bible says, then let's go to that offender. Atin po ang process natin, diba? Let's go to that offender or brothers and sisters in the Lord. Kapatid, medyo nasaktan ako sa sinabi mo, hindi ko kinakayay. But that's the right thing to do. At kung hindi niya, hindi ay, masyado ba naman pasailan? Pumunta ko sa, ano, sa pastor's office. Isama mo si pastor, eh, nagsumbong pa. Diba? Eh, yun po sabi sa Biblia, diba? Kung hindi talaga kayo kaibigin, then let the Bible speak na meron na pong next process. Okay, to end this simple message, tatlong R po that hinder us to have a happy and blessed life. Rebellion, resistance, resentment. Okay? Now, these are the evidences of the experience of forgiveness. Para po sa pagpapatawad, ito po yung maganda mangyari. Tatlo po, a wonder at God's forgiveness. Makikita mo, ma-appreciate mo kapag kapangyarihan ng Panginoon magpatawad kung nagpapatawad ka. Tenderness towards others. Hindi ka masyadong sensitive. No? Pangalawa, peace that guards the heart from being easily offended. Mas matibay na puso. Okay? So, mabilis lang ito. Six things that can help you have a happy heart. Counter blessings, number one. Number two, develop close human relationship. Brothers and sisters of the Lord, that's important. Tatlo, pangatlo, train up a wise and good of God children. Pangapat, set and achieve good goals. Number five, avoid critical people. Narinig niyo ang kasabihan na, tell me who your friends are, and I'll tell you mine. Kasabihan tayo sa inyong friends. Develop an attitude of gratitude. And the result of this is this. There are three characteristics of having a happy heart. Increased physical vitality, improved physical appearance. Yan. Wala na akong talong-talong kung ang kasalubong mo ay busangot ang mukha, alam nila kung anong pinagumukutan niya. Pero kung ikaw ay katulad ni Darwin, kaya si Darwin gusto ko lagi makita every morning. Talagang kakainig ka ng smile nito eh. Pwede yata mag-model ng toothpaste or toothbrush to. Si kaya Darwin, I love the way he smiles at yung kanyang baby boy. Baby boy ba? Whatever, pagaling mag-smile. Okay? And of course, number three, it enables you to live above the circumstance. May problema man sa buhay, masaya pa rin. Kaya nga sa awit, kahit may problema at wala kang pera, di ba laging masaya? Diba? Yun ang bunga ng kapayapaan at presensya ng banal na Panginoon sa buhay natin. You want to be happy? Is it possible for us to be happy?
Yes.
It is. Always. That's the desire of the Lord towards His children. A happy household of faith. Let us pray. Father, we thank You for You are the source of joy, gladness, and everything in between na positive, Panginoon. You are the superlative of what we can think of good things sa buhay namin. You're always exceeding sa lahat na amin na-expect. At salamat, Panginoon, for You are indeed present sa buhay namin once we receive Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior. Simultaneous things happen, and one of the things that we receive from You, fruit of the Spirit, is joy na hindi ko kayang bayaran o tumbasan sa libutan ito. Kayo lamang po ang nakapagbigay. So let this joy be something na puhubutin namin sa aming being, and it will create a happy face, a good physical vitality, and everyone will be happy as well. Especially mga mahal namin sa buhay, katrabaho namin, there is something different sa buhay ng tao ito, and that is because Jesus is in our hearts. That will result in a happy heart. Bless His truth in our hearts, in Jesus' name, Amen.